In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
It is Thursday, the 12th of October, 2023. 27th week in ordinary time, and participating in the proclamation of the word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members: Clatus Mulenga from Kabwe, Zambia, celebrating his birthday today, takes for us the first reading. Dona Asimwe Kusemererwa, celebrating her birthday today, from Ohima in Uganda, takes for us the responsorial psalm. And proclaiming the gospel is Father Godwin Apesu, celebrating his priestly anniversary today, from Lafia Diocese in Nigeria. And we also pray for the following Daily Bread members celebrating their birthdays today: Miriam Daka from Lusaka, Zambia, Joanna Change from Bulawayo, Zimbabwe, Lisa Kunda from Mazabuka, Zambia, Epifania Mukandi Mazikana from Windhoek, Namibia, and Dananai Mashapure from Harare, Zimbabwe. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who in the abundance of your kindness surpass the merits and the desires of those who entreat you, pour out your mercy upon us to pardon what conscience dreads and to give what prayer does not dare to ask. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
The first reading. Behold, the day comes burning like an oven. A reading from the book of the prophet Malachi. Malachi chapter 3, verse 13 to 4 to 2a. Your words have been stored against me, says the Lord. Yet you say, how have we spoken against you? You have said, it is vain to serve God. What is the good of our keeping his charge or of walking as in mourning before the Lord of hosts? Henceforth, we deem the arrogant blessed. Evildoers not only prosper, but when they put God to the test, they escape. Then those who feared the Lord spoke with one another. The Lord heeded and heard them, and a book of remembrance was written before him of those who feared the Lord and thought on his name. They shall be mine, says the Lord of hosts, my special possession on the day when I act, and I will spare them as a man spares his son who saves him. Then, once more, you shall distinguish between the righteous and the wicked, between one who saves God and one who does not save him. For behold, the day comes burning like an oven, when all the arrogant and all evildoers will be stumble. The day that comes shall burn them up, says the Lord of hosts, so that it will leave them neither root nor branch. But for you who fear my name, the Son of Righteousness shall rise with healing in its wings. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm, Psalm 1, verse 1 to 2, 3, 4, and 6. The response is taken from Psalm 40, verse 5ab. And the response is, blessed the man who has placed his trust in the Lord.
Blessed the man who has placed his trust in the Lord.
Blessed indeed is the man who follows not the counsel of the wicked, nor stands in the path with sinners, nor abides in the company of scorners, but whose delight is the law of the Lord, and who ponders his law day and night.
Blessed the man who has placed his trust in the Lord.
He is like a tree that is planted beside the flowing waters, that yields its fruit in due season, and whose leaves shall never fade, and all that he does shall prosper.
Blessed the man who has placed his trust in the Lord.
Not so are the wicked, not so. For they, like winnowed chaff, shall be driven away by the wind. For the Lord knows the way of the just, but the way of the wicked will perish.
Blessed the man who has placed his trust in the Lord.
The gospel acclamation is from Acts chapter 16, verse 14b.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Open our hearts, O Lord, that we may give heed to the words of your Son.
Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Luke chapter 11, verses 5 to 13. At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, which of you who has a friend will go to him at midnight and said to him, friend, lend me 3 loaves, for a friend of mine has arrived on a journey, and I have nothing to set before him. And he will answer from within, do not bother me, the door is now shut, and my children are with me in bed. I cannot get up and give you anything. I tell you, though he will not get up and give him anything because he is his friend, yet because of his importunity, he will rise and give him whatever he needs. And I tell you, ask, it will be given you. Seek, and you will find. Knock, and it will be opened to you. For everyone who asks, receives. And he who seeks, finds. And to him who knocks, it will be opened. What father among you, if his son asks for a fish, will instead of a fish give him a serpent? Or if he asks for an egg, will give him a scorpion? If you then, who are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will the Heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him? The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We are almost done with post-exilic writings, and we are with Prophet Malachi, which is the last book in the Old Testament, but not the last to be written. After the Jews had returned from their exile, the prophet Haggai and Zechariah supported them in the task of rebuilding the temple and the restoration of the nation. But after the initial enthusiasm had died down, the people tended to drift from their religious practices. This is where the prophet Malachi steps in. The Hebrew word Malachi means my messenger. But when did he step in? Since some of the problems addressed in Malachi are also addressed by Nehemiah and Ezra, such as foreign wives, Malachi chapter 2 verse 10 to 12, Nehemiah chapter 13 verse 3, Ezra chapter 9 verse 1 to 15, inadequate temple administration, Malachi chapter 1 verse 6 to chapter 2 verse 9, and then Nehemiah chapter 12 verse 44 to 47, we could place Malachi before the time of Ezra, that is about 450 BC. The Synoptic Gospels, that is Matthew, Mark, and Luke, quote Malachi chapter 3 verse 1. Now I'm sending my messenger ahead of me to clear the way, when speaking of the beginning of the Messianic age at the preaching of John the Baptist. Malachi chapter 3 verse 5 lists a group of wrongdoers who are soon to be judged by God. These include sorcerers, adulterers, those who swear falsely, and those who oppress hired workers, widows and orphans, and even foreigners. Now, we see that the last passage in the book foresees the coming of Elijah, the eschatological prophet who is to introduce the last times. Jesus says that John the Baptist was the Elijah. That's why this book is placed the last, though it was not the last to be written. But it is placed the last because of that last passage which ushers in the new covenant. The gospel passage of today is a continuation of yesterday. It's about prayer. That is why in tonight's Good Night message, I would like to focus on prayer. The Lord wants to emphasize that prayer is answered. Because the disciples asked him, teach us to pray. But then we say, why should we be praying if there is nothing coming out of prayer? In responding to that, Jesus tells them, prayer is answered. There is everything that comes out of prayer. You may not see the change. You may not see things happening because you have been knocking. You have been pressing that door for a very long time. You have been trying to knock, looking for answers to your problem, and you don't see the answer coming too soon. Don't be too quick in waiting for an answer. The answer will come. If you are confident in the person you are praying to say he's God who answers prayer, then you're not going to give up on prayer. That's it. Those people who give up on prayer are those who don't know the God they are praying to. If you know the God you are praying to, you will pray with confidence that if he doesn't answer today, he's going to answer tomorrow. Which of you, having a friend, will go to him at midnight and say to him, friend, lend me 3 loaves, for a friend of mine has arrived on a journey, and I have nothing to set before him. And he will answer from in, do not bother me, the door is now shut. And some people end there with their prayer. They pray once, because they don't see God responding to them. And when they hear him respond, they don't see a positive answer. They give up on prayer. Now, this man doesn't give up on prayer. He insists. And we are told, I tell you, though he will not get up and give him anything because he is his friend, yet because of his importunity, he will rise and give him whatever he needs. Friendship. That is a relationship, though he will not get up on the basis of relationship, because he said in the Our Father, start with Our Father, start with a relationship, and then ask for what you need. And the others will say, yes, that's what we are doing now, but we're not getting anything. Yes, keep on pressing like the way Catholics do with their rosary. They keep saying, Hail Mary, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Not once, not twice, 10 times 5, 50 times. They are just repeating that. It is importunity. Learn from us. I pray the rosary every day because it reminds me of the importunity I must have for God to respond to me. Why? Because he says when you press on something, when you hit on something, even if it may be too hard, it will be softened. That's our God. And he responds to us. He says, ask and you shall be given. Seek and you shall find. Knock and the door shall be opened unto you. And he wants us to be that persevering, that strong in our prayer life. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Thursday to you.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread.
Your